Hey everyone, my name is Krisha. I'll be guiding you in your practice today. So for class, what you'll need is a yoga mat, two yoga blocks, and a yoga strap. If you haven't otherwise, if you don't totally fine, you're welcome to use a hand towel. Otherwise, anything that's like similar in size that can support you, like if you have like household items, like maybe Lysol wipes, baby wipes, two of those, we'll be using that for class today. So today what I have planned out for class is we'll be getting into some shoulder stretches, some heart openers, a little bit of balancing, I think. I'm trying to remember what I had planned for class. And towards the end, when we slow it down, we'll be taking it on to the floor and getting into some hip openers. So with that being said, let's all get started in a kneeling position. And then if you like a little bit more support, you're welcome to take a block, maybe a pillow underneath your sits bones, and finding your hands, placing it onto your lap for grounding. Otherwise, if you need a little bit more opening, you're welcome to bring your palms facing up. Just start to drift the eyes close. Begin to deepen their breath. Feeling the rib cage expand every time you inhale. And as you exhale, slowly let the breath out. Take a couple deep breaths just to really settle into your space, settle into your practice today. And as we sit here, just beginning to start our class, I invite you just to explore your why. I know sometimes it can be challenging and hard just with everything that's going on, and maybe sometimes we've drifted from our why. Maybe we're just going through the motions through our routines, and that's totally okay. Just acknowledge it, let it go, and I invite you to ask to return to your why. And even then, if you're still wondering what that why is, I invite you to think of someone or something that inspires you. And as you practice, just let that ground you into your space, into your flow, and let it push you, let it inspire you to do more, to be more. And as you fill in, as you breathe in, creating space. As you exhale, focusing on what inspires you. When you're ready, blink the eyes open. On your inhale, reach the hands up high over the head. And just right getting into alignment, slight tuck of the tailbone under. Scoop the navel in, drift your shoulders directly over your hips, and draw the chin back. Reach your fingertips high, 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 and plug the shoulders back into your sockets. And as you reach up, reach for whatever you need today. Maybe it's more love, strength, patience, whatever you need, reaching up. And as you exhale, making some fists to hold onto it, grab it. Pull the triceps back. Reach just a little bit higher. Keep this navel in. As you exhale, start to curl your wrist in towards your body. And then keep that motion going as you lower your arms. Just slowly taking everything in, finding a nice wrist stretch, expanding your arms, and then eventually letting your wrist hover right beside your hips. And then once you get to the bottom, we'll switch the direction out, circle the wrists the other way, towards the outside. Again, coming back in the same motion that we came in, circling the wrist all the way until you reach up at the sky. Taking your time to get there, maybe feeling just a little bit warmer, keeping the fists nice and strong. When you're ready, slowly release the grip. On your inhale, interlace the hands over your head. As you exhale, reach the palms up toward the sky. Draw the shoulders directly over your hips, reaching the shoulders down as you lift up through the heart. As you exhale, follow my voice. Bring the hands through heart center, reaching the back of your hands forward. Bring the shoulders back into its sockets. Keep the arms nice and long. Maybe gently pull the fingertips apart. And we'll flow a couple more times that way. Bring the hands to heart center, rising the arms up. Yogi choice, if you'd like to find a little back bend, maybe open the throat. Exhale, hands to heart center, round the shoulders and chest. Hold it here, keep it going. Inhale, comes through heart center, open it up. Exhale through heart center, palms facing back. Now we're gonna take it to just one motion. Flip the palms, rising all the way up, maybe a little back bend. Exhale, flip the palms around through the back. One more time, flip the palms. Arch the back, drop the shoulders away from the ears, create space. Exhale, palms facing forward, tuck the chin to the chest, round through the back. Nice job, gently release your hands by your lap. And then start to roll your shoulders, maybe roll out your neck. And then switch it around, roll your shoulders forward. Maybe roll the neck in the opposite direction. Nice job, guys. If you have the block, release the block from your hips and make your way to a tabletop position. Hands underneath the shoulders, knees underneath the hips. And as you're ready, start to find your own movement sitting. Maybe you're swaying the hips side to side. Maybe you're swaying your shoulders. Maybe you're flipping your fingertips to find an extra wrist stretch. Just doing whatever feels good in your body today. This is so much your practice, I'm just your guide. So whatever feels good for you, if you need to hold something extra or slow it down, please feel free to go there. And a couple more deep breaths, doing to one side whatever you did to the other, switch it out. When you're ready, we'll meet back in that tabletop position, toes tucked under, grip into the earth. Listen, shift the weight to the right, fire hydrant on the left side. Open your left knee in line with the left hip. Make sure you have a 90 degree angle on your calf and on your thigh. Be mindful of your shoulders, square the shoulders toward the front of the room, tummy is tight. Inhale, reach the left knee higher. As you exhale, start to circle the knee towards the front of the room. Again, press equally into both hands. Last circle, bringing it forward. And then once the knee meets back up where it started, circle the other way, back pedal. Keep that foot flexed. Keep the arms nice and strong. Keep the core engaged. Last one, and we'll meet back in fire hydrant position. Left thigh is parallel. Gaze to the left. When you're ready, begin to kick out that left heel. Make sure that heel is in line with the hip, not lower, not higher. Hold it here for three. Shift the weights equally between both hands for two. And one, listen, close that left hip. Shoulders strongly over the hips. Make sure you're not dipping into your back, press into it. Inhale, dragging your fingertips back as you reach your heart forward. Exhale, knee to nose, touch round through the back, tuck the chin to the chest. Maybe kiss your knee. Inhale, extend the leg long, maybe find a little bit cow. Reach the foot towards the sky, drag your fingertips back, reach your heart forward. As you exhale, listen, left knee to left tricep, touch, hold it higher. Then gently plant the foot outside the left hand. When you're ready, grabbing your blocks or your household items, place it on your mat, tuck the back toes under, make your way to low lunge with your blocks. And just setting up the alignment, push your foot back. Imagine you have a wall behind you so that your foot and the ball of your foot touch that back wall. Left knee in close to the elbow. Press into your hands. Your props are an extension of your hands. On your inhale, cow lunge. Drop the hips low, roll the shoulders down, reach the heart up. Maybe gentle open of the throat, reach the chin higher. Tummy is tight, squeeze inner thighs together, drop the hips low, heart higher. As you exhale, keep your hands and feet as they are. Cat lunge, straighten both legs, round the chin to the chest, and press through your hands to round the shoulders. Squeeze inner thighs, you wanna bunch the mat underneath you, tummy is tight. Then we'll get ready to flow one breath to one movement. On your inhale, cow lunge. Drop the hips slow, reach the heart high. Bring the knee close to the elbow. Exhale, cat lunge, round through the back. Push the earth away from you. One more time, inhale, cow lunge. Hips slow, heart high. Exhale, cat lunge. You better stop. And then when you're ready, make your way back to low lunge. Release your blocks or your props if you have them. And as you exhale, hold it here. This is layer one. Looking for deeper. Again, make sure that your knee is in line with the ankle. Deeper, crawl the fingertips forward. Be mindful of the spine. Drag your fingertips back, reach your heart forward, and then melt it closer to the earth. Holding for three. Holding for two. And make sure you're not rounding through the spine. Really reach with your heart. Exhale, hold for one. Claw your hands, one hand, print back if they're reached forward. Shift the weight to the front foot. Make your way to a froggy pose. So your feet is as wide as the mat I'm gonna face you. Layer one, elbows to the knees. Layer two, hands to heart center. Open the elbows wide, drop the tailbone. Shift your shoulders directly over your hips. You can sway side to side if that feels good. Connecting back to the breath. Connecting back to the body. When you're ready, release your hands to the mat. On your inhale, raise the hips high. Toes are gonna pivot towards the center. Exhale, froggy pose, drop the hips low. Two more that way, keep the belly tight. Raise the hips. Exhale, froggy pose, open the knees wider. Last one, raise the hips high. Spine is long, exhale, froggy pose. Nice job, guys. I'm gonna take it a little bit more flowy. On your inhale, hands to the mat. Raise the hips high, adding on, sweep the earth. Reaching the arms all the way up, tummy is tight. Exhale, soften the knees, hands to heart center. Two more, inhale. Hips up, arms to the sky. Exhale, fold, bend through the knees. Last one, rise the hips up, arms up. Exhale, fold. Soften the knees, plant the hands to the mat, raise the hips high, and bring your feet hips distance apart. Ragdoll pose, let the head and neck drop heavy. Bring them to interlace the hands behind your head, otherwise tuck the hands into opposite elbow creases. Engage the core, roll more weight forward. Micro bend to your knees that no one can see and only you can feel. Welcome to sway side to side if that's in your practice today. When you're ready, begin to slow down. Release your hands to the mat. Bring your toes and feet to touch. Bend in the knees and then tuck the chin to the chest. Unravel the spine vertebra by vertebra. Eventually, shoulders glide up to the ears and slide down the back. Inhale, Tadasana, reach the hands up to the sky. As you exhale, Samasthiti, bring the hands to heart center. The right to it. Inhale, Tadasana, mountain pose. Reach the arms up, up, up. Then lift all 10 toes off the mat, firmly plant them down. Slight tuck of the tailbone under. Engage, of course, begin to activate the quadriceps. Pull the arms back. Inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, back bend. Option for hands to the low back, layer one, layer two. Maybe cactus the arms, squeeze the elbow tips behind you, lift up through your heart. Exhale, fold deeper. Hold it here and breathe for three. Four, two, maybe look for the mat behind you. And one, inhale, lift your arms up to the sky, mountain pose. As you exhale, interlace the hands behind you. Cover layer today. So this right here is layer two. We're gonna be holding this for a moment. If you need a little extra more support, more length, you're welcome to take your strap or your yoga block. It doesn't have to be fancy. You can hold on to that right here to give you more space. So once you have your interlaced hands, on your inhale, straight to the elbows, lift up through your heart, little back bend. As you exhale, four, fold, lead with the heart. Keep the belly tight. Let the head and neck fall heavy. Relax your shoulders away from the ears and use your interlaced hands as a weight to take you just a little bit deeper. You're welcome to make a little figure eight with your hands if that feels good with your shoulders. And bring it back to stillness. Adding on your inhale, keep the hands interlaced. Inhale, halfway lift. Shoulder is in line with your hips from this side. You look like an upside down L. As you exhale, follow my voice, bend the left knee, rotate your gaze to the right, let the ribs stack, shoulders down. Exhale, twist deeper. Inhale, halfway lift. Shoulders are in line with the hips. Other side, exhale, bend the right knee, let the ribs stack, gaze to the left, arms go back. Tummy is tight, let it lift off the thighs. Inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, forward fold with control, release the grip. On your inhale, halfway lift, hands to the shins. Lengthen through the crown of the head. Exhale, high plank and hold. Hands underneath the shoulders, feet hip distance apart. And again, get to that alignment. Gently tuck the tailbone under, but don't let it droop. Let it stand nice and strong. Puff up through the shoulders, squeeze the inner thighs together. And with control, roll 2 inches forward. Lower down halfway for 4. 3, 2. Hold at that halfway point. Let this elbow squeeze, puff up through the shoulders for 4. Breathe. 3. Squeeze inner thighs. 2. And 1. Gently release your belly to the mat. Nice job, guys. Let's take a quick shoulder stretch. Tee out the left arm. Right heel kisses the glute and roll up and over the body. Couple layers today. Right hand, layer 1, stays to the mat. Layer 2, right hand to the right hip. Layer 3, interlace the hands behind you. And if you have this connection, bring the palms to touch. Shoulders down, squeeze the shoulder blades behind you for 3, 2, and 1. Unwind, roll back onto the belly. Other side, tee out the right arm, left hand underneath the shoulder. Left heel kisses the glute, roll up and over, other side. And you guys know your layers today, going whatever feels good to you. Maybe staying here, maybe hand to the hip. Maybe interlace the hands behind you. And then reach your heart forward as you squeeze your shoulder blades, your palms back for 3. 2. Breathe, and 1. Gently release. Rolling onto the belly, hands underneath the shoulders. Tuck the toes under and make your way back through tabletop position. I'm gonna switch the other way, that way I can keep showing you what we're doing. So once you're over here, shifting the weight to the left side, fire hydrant on the right leg. So again, that leg is in a 90 degree angle with your thigh and your calf. Be mindful of your shoulders. Make sure that they're square towards the front of the room. Nose up, dipping into the front, puff up through your heart. Inhale, reach that knee higher. Exhale, circle the knee towards the front of the room. Keep the core engaged. Be mindful that the bigger the knee circle, the bigger the hip opener. Then once you've done your third rotation, take it back, rewind. Again, be mindful of where your arms are at in space. Press equally into both hands. Last one, then we'll be back in fire hydrant. Right thigh parallel, gaze to the right. Then when you're ready, kick out that leg nice and strong. You want to plant your footprint on the sidewall. Right heel higher. Exhale, close the hip, take that right leg back. Again, be mindful of your low back. Make sure you're not dumping into it. Puff up through your shoulders. Keep the integrity of the spine. Exhale, right knee to nose. Tuck around through your shoulders, just like an angry cat. Inhale, cow extension. Extend the right leg long, maybe up. Drag your fingertips back, reach your heart forward. Exhale, right knee to right tricep touch. Hold it here. Then quietly, gracefully plant the foot outside the hand. Nice job, guys. Tuck the back toes under. Grab your props, whatever they are. Tuck back toes, let's make our way to low lunge. Again, set it up, draw the right hip back, left hip forward. Shoulders in line with the wrist. On your inhale, cow lunge. Drop the hips low, squeeze inner thighs. Keep that right knee close to the elbow. Press into the hands and reach your heart up, tummy is tight. Again, drop the hips low, press into the earth. Reach the chin to the sky. This should feel like an awesome hip shift. Exhale, cat lunge. Keep everything as they are and begin to straighten the legs. Scissor kick the inner thighs together. Keep the core engaged. Press the earth away from you. When you're ready, let's flow. On your inhale, cow lunge. Hips low, heart high. Keep that back leg nice and strong. Exhale, cat lunge. Round through the back. One more time. Inhale, cow lunge. Activate that left quadricep. Let the kneecap come up. Exhale, cat lunge. Nice job, guys. Let's take it back to low lunge. Set the blocks aside. A couple layers today. Layer 1, staying here. If you like looking for deeper, crawl your fingertips forward or forward. And again, be mindful of what your spine looks like. No rounding through the back. Shoulders down. Reach with your heart forward. Then eventually, heart starts to melt toward the earth. 4, 3. Breathe, keep that up, that knee close to that shoulder, 4, 2. And 1. If your hands are out further, bring the one hand print back. Shift the weight forward, make your way back to that froggy pose. I'm gonna face you guys now. So again, your feet are as wide as the mat. Hands to the earth first, drop the hips low, open the knees wide. You're gonna take a different variation. With your left hand, you're gonna take the back of your hand, swing it behind you to make a chicken wing with your elbow. With the elbow, take it forward of your knee, drop the hips low, stack your shoulders directly over your hips. Taking your opposite hand to the shoulder, gently find a pectoral stretch, gently open the knee wide, open the elbow wide, tummy is tight. Again, drop the hips low, stack the shoulders directly over the hips. And then gently release, other side. Right hand swings to the low back, elbow to the front of that right knee. Drop the hips low, shoulder stack over the hips. Find that shoulder and gently let it open. Opening that shoulder wider, opening that knee wider, and breathe. Coming back to the breath. As you exhale, gently release, plant the hands, raise the hips high, bring your feet and toes to touch. We'll flow, sun in, one breath to one movement. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the earth, tadasana, arms to the sky. As you exhale, baby back bend, maybe squeeze your elbows behind your cactus. Inhale, tadasana. Exhale, interlace the hands behind you. You're welcome to use your strap or your towel if you like. Inhale, back bend. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, Ardha Uttanasana, halfway lift. As you exhale, bend the left knee, turn the gaze to the right. Inhale, halfway lift, come back center. Exhale, bend the right knee, other side, gaze left. Inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, release your hands with control. One more time, inhale, halfway lift. As you exhale, chaturanga, high plank to low plank, lower down halfway, just like a push-up. Inhale, upward facing dog, release your toes to the mat. Knees and thighs lift up, exhale, downward facing dog. Nice job, first down dog of the day. Maybe you're walking it out, raising one heel, lifting the other. Maybe you come up high to the tippy toes, maybe you stretch out some toes, bringing the tops of the feet to the earth. Yogi choice, and then once you have it, return to stillness. Press into your finger pads to release any stress on the wrist. Squeeze your elbows tight together, press into the hands, tummy is tight. Relax your shoulders. Find a little cow pose in your tailbone, reaching it toward the sky. As you exhale, belly button up and in, fold your heart closer to the thighs. You want to extend your spine as long as possible from the crown of the head all the way to the tailbone. Let's flow one more time, you guys got this. On your inhale, set the gaze forward. As you exhale, step or jump to the top of your mat. Yogi choice. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, sweep the earth, tadasana, arms to the sky. Exhale, back bend. Squeeze your elbows behind you. Inhale, tadasana. Exhale, interlace the hands behind the low back. Inhale, back bend with the arms. Exhale, forward fold. Raise your arms high over the head. Inhale, halfway lift, shoulders in line with the hips. As you exhale, bend the left knee, tilt the gaze to the right. Inhale, come back center, core strong. Exhale, bend the right knee, tilt the gaze to the left. Inhale, come back center. Exhale, forward fold, with control, release your grip. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is lengthened. Exhale, chaturanga, just like that push-up, high plank to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog, let the knees and thighs lift off the mat. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, set the gaze forward. Exhale, travel to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose, bend the knees, sit low, reach the arms up, 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 up. Nice job, guys. Now, sit like you mean it. Imagine you're actually sitting in the chair. Swing the weight back, sit low, tummy is tight. You can lift all 10 toes off the floor, then firmly plant them into the earth. Engage the core. Sit just a little bit deeper. Squeeze knees, inner thighs together. Reach the arms up. As you exhale, simple twist. Reach the right arm back. Left arm is forward of you. Reach the arms in opposite directions and bring the shoulders back into its sockets. Keep the hips square towards the front of the room. Draw the left hip back, right hip forward. Sit just a little bit deeper and breathe. Nice job, guys. Follow my voice. Shift the weight to the right foot on your inhale. Start to step back, low lunge, simple twist. Step back with the left foot, left hand plants. Nice job, guys. This is where you're at today. A couple of layers, if you're looking for extra support, you're welcome to bring your left hand to a block or your prop. Otherwise, draw the shoulders away from the ears. Exhale, twist deeper. Again, let the shoulders and wrists be in one line. Let the ribs stack. Inhale, lengthen, reach the right arm higher. Tummy is tight, squeeze inner thighs. Exhale, reach the right arm towards the back wall. You're drawing a circle on the side wall. Right arm sweeps to earth, reach your right arm up to the sky. As you exhale, circle it forward towards the front of the room this time. Sweep your earth, right arm up to the sky. Nice job, guys, listen. Left hand, tense the fingertips, come up high into your fingertips. Start to get light in the left hand, squeeze inner thighs. As you exhale, use your core, reach your right arm back as you reach the left arm forward. Your shoulders are square towards your mat. And then again, find some length. Instead of drooping to the back, extend, extend. Activate your core, let the tummy lift off the side. Make sure that back heel is directly over the ball of the foot. On your inhale, fierce pulse, just the right arm reaches forward. You have an imaginary block in your hand, squeeze it. Bring the shoulders back in socket, into the socket. Last breath. Exhale, pull the left arm back and make your way to warrior two. First warrior two of the day. You're welcome to take a couple of knee bounces. And then again, once you have it, really commit to it. Come back to your why, come back to your intention. By that heel to arch alignment, that front heel is matched in to the middle of that back arch. 90 degree angle and the front foot. Press into the big toe mound, press all the way to that back pinky toe. Take up space, slight tuck of the tailbone under. Nice job, guys. On your inhale, reverse warrior. Straighten both legs. Left arm down. Reach right arm up to the sky. Be mindful of that back hip. Make sure you're not sassing it up. Bring it underneath your shoulders. Reach up higher. Exhale, extended side angle. Bend that front knee. There, one forearm to that front leg. There, two right elbow to the inside of the knee. Extend the arm. Reach left arm up to the sky. And just like we've been playing with, drop the shoulders away from the ears. Stack the ribs, let your heart shine toward the sky. Couple of layers today of this. The forearm is layer one, onto the side, layer two is over here. Layer three, if you'd like, left hand to the low back, find that bind. If you have that bind, begin to straighten the arms, and instead of staying low here, try to find some length. Extend your elbows, long shoulders up, exhale, twist your heart, holding for three. And one, inhale, extended side angle. Release your arms as you exhale. Plant your left hand to the earth, low lunge. Inhale, three-legged dog, right toes to the sky. Exhale, chaturanga. Option for ekapada, keeping that right foot floating. Inhale, upward facing dog, untuck the toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice job, guys, taking one cleansing breath, breathing in. Open up, exhale, let it go. Let's do this. Inhale, set the gaze forward. Exhale, step or jump to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose, bend the knees, sit low, reach the arms all the way up. You guys have been here before. Shift the weight back. As you exhale, simple twist, open the left arm back. Once you're here, be mindful of your hips. Draw the right hip back, left hip forward. Shift your shoulders directly over your hips. Sit just a little bit deeper because you can. Smiling makes it easier. Extend your arms in opposite directions. Your best friends are fighting over you. Exhale, bring the shoulders back into its sockets. Shift the weight to the left foot. Low lunge, simple twist. Step the right hand back. Plant the right hand to the floor. Again, if you used a block or prop on the other side, please feel free to go there. Squeeze inner thighs together, press into the bottom hand, reach through the top hand. As you exhale, draw that circle. Left arm extends toward the back wall. Let it sweep the earth. Open up. Inhale at the top. As you exhale, circle the left arm forward. Tummy is tight. Nice job, guys. Inhale, reach left arm up to the sky. Now, be mindful of the right hand. Come up high into the fingertips. Tummy is tight. As you exhale, engage the core, drift your left hand towards the back. As you reach your right arm forward, square the shoulders directly towards your mat. Again, squeeze inner thighs to get the balance. Inhale, fierce pose, left hand reaches with the right. As you exhale, warrior two, pull it back, plant that back heel to the earth. First warrior two on this side today. Maybe you're extending and bending that front knee a couple of times. And then again, once you have it, really commit to it. Stay low. Externally rotating that front thigh. So opening that knee closer to that pinky toe, internally rotating that back thigh, squeezing the inner thighs together. Find that scissor kick. Extend your arms far apart. Make sure your shoulders directly over the hips, sit low. Take the sway out of the back, tuck the hips under. Reach through the crown of the head. Inhale, reverse warrior, squeeze inner thighs, reaching all the way up through your fingertips, breathing in, lengthen. Exhale, extended side angle, bend the front knee. So many options today, forearm to the front leg, layer two, elbow to the knee, reach your right arm up to the sky and stay. Again, soften the shoulders away from the ears. Use the elbow and knee as leverage to twist deeper. Breathe. And then if finding a bind is in your practice, you're welcome to bring your hand to the low back. If you can't reach, you're welcome to use your hand towel or your strap to create length. Drop the shoulders away from the ears. Begin to extend the arms long, maybe step through. Again, find some lift, holding for three. Holding for two. And one, release the grip. Plant the hands, reach right arm up. Exhale, low lunge, both hands to the earth. Inhale, three-legged dog, left toes to the sky. Exhale, chaturanga, high plank to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog, hold it here. Nice job, guys. Take three cleansing breaths, breathing in. Fill up, open mouth, exhale, ha. Let out some heat, two more. Fill up again, you guys got it. Ha, last breath. Let it go. Let's flow one breath to one movement. We'll switch up just a little because you can. Let's do this. Inhale, step against the board. Exhale, step or jump to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose, bend the knees, sit low, arms all the way up. As you exhale, simple twist, reach your right arm back, sit just a little bit deeper. Inhale, low lunge, simple twist, shift the weight to the right, step the left foot back. Moving on your inhale, reach the right arm back, left arm forward, shoulder square towards the earth. Inhale, fierce pose, extend the right arm long. Exhale, warrior two, hook that back heel to the earth, sit low. Adding on, inhale, reverse warrior, just the upper body moves, stay low in that front leg. Exhale, extended side angle, tick-tock the arms, right arm down, left arm up. Inhale, circle left arm toward the back wall. As you exhale, low lunge, both hands plant. Inhale, three-legged dog, right toes to the sky. As you exhale, adding on, left knee to left tricep, touch and hold. Hold it here, pop it through the arm. Right shoulder back, left shoulder forward. Hug that knee just a little bit higher. Woo! Inhale, three-legged dog. Exhale, chaturanga, high plank to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog, untuck the toes, collarbone long. Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice job, guys. One more flow, let's do this. Right to inhale, step the gaze forward. Exhale, journey to the top of your mat. Inhale, halfway lift, spine is long. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, chair pose. Sit low, arms all the way up, squeeze inner thighs. Exhale, simple twist, left arm reaches back, sit just a little bit deeper. Shift the weight to the left foot. Inhale, low lunge, simple twist, step the right foot back, left arm up. Exhale, left arm reaches back, right arm reaches forward. Your upper body is square towards the earth. Inhale, fierce pose, extend the left arm long. Again, keep the integrity of the low back. Exhale, warrior two, hook that back heel to the earth. Inhale, reverse warrior, just the upper body moves. Exhale, extended side angle, tick-tock the arm, stay low in that front leg. Inhale, circle the right arm toward the back wall. As you exhale, low lunge, both hands plant. Inhale, three-legged dog, left toes to the sky. Adding on, exhale, left knee to right tricep, cross and hold. Again, puff up through the shoulders, left shoulder back, right shoulder forward. Bring that knee higher. Inhale, three-legged dog. As you exhale, chaturanga, high plank to low plank. Inhale, upward facing dog, shoulders down.
Exhale, downward facing dog. Nice job, guys. You did it. Inhale, step the gaze forward. Make your way to high plank and with control, come all the way to the belly for four, three, two, and one. Nice job, guys. Untuck the toes, bringing your forearms to a number 11. I'm gonna move this so I can show you what we're doing. Place your elbows underneath your shoulders. Make your way to Sphinx pose. Grip into the earth as you drag your fingertips back. Press your hips into the earth, reaching your hips forward, shoulders down. Lift up through the heart. Again, always finding extension through the spine, the crown of the head. Relax your glutes and actively press your hips. Breathe, come back to your breath. Nice job, guys. As you exhale, bending that right elbow, right forearm in towards the opposite elbow. Hug the left heel to the left glute. Press into the forearm, reach the left arm up and over, grab the top of your foot, and then square your shoulders toward the front of the room as you bring your heel closer to the glute. Press into the hand. Keep the spine as long as possible. So this is layer one, your fingertips are to the back. To take it deeper, switch your grip, fingertips are toward the front of the room, square your shoulders to the front. Holding for three and breathe. Press into that bottom arm, four, two, and one. Gently release your grip. Extending the arms in that Sphinx shape, making it number 11. We're gonna take to half froggy pose. So bending the left knee towards the left side, you're in a half froggy pose shape. Your knee and your hip are in one line. You should create a 90 degree angle with that thigh and that calf, just like we did for a fire hydrant position. So this is where we're gonna hold it for a moment, and you can make this as active as you want. You can stay here pressing into your elbows, pressing your shoulders. And then to activate the legs, you're going to be pressing into that left knee and then letting it drag towards, drag away from you. And then if you're keeping it active with the left knee, imagine you want to reach your left inner thigh closer to the earth. Holding for three. Breathe. Shoulders down, lengthen through the spine. Four, two. And one. Right elbow. The right forearm is going to pivot in. Bring the right heel to the right cheek. Left arm reaches up and over. Bring that heel to the opposite cheek and then square your shoulders toward the front of the room. Hold it here for three. Four, two. And one. Gently release your legs long. Let your arms lay long. Drop the right ear, right cheek to the earth. Let it go. Maybe gentle sway in the hips side to side. And bring your chin back center, rising up into that Sphinx shape. Make that number 11. Left forearm is going to pivot in right here to the cheek. And then grabbing the top of your feet. Again, be mindful of your shoulders. Square them towards the front of the room. And then start to encourage that big toe closer to the right cheek. You know your layers today. Layer one, your fingertips are facing the back wall. Layer two, flip the grip. Maybe that elbow is pointed toward the sky. Hold it here. Press into that bottom arm. Four, three. Four, two. And one. Gently release. Making a Sphinx pose with your forearms. I'm going to face this way to show you what's going on. And when you're ready, we'll make our way to that half froggy pose. The right knee is in line with that right hip. Again, make that 90 degree angle. Shoulders down, press into the earth. You can stay here, pressing to the shoulders and to the elbows. Otherwise, a little bit more active half froggy pose. Press into that right knee and then drag the right knee away from you as you actively reach your inner thigh toward the earth. Tummy is tight. Press into that bottom hand. Press into the forearms for three. Four, two, and one. Left forearm rotates in front of you. Bend the right heel to the glute. Reach up and over to the opposite foot. And then again, square your shoulders toward the front of the room. Press into the left hand, left arm. For three. Four, two, and one. Extend the legs long. Right ear, right cheek to the earth. Let it go. Broken to sway the hips side to side again. And if you're looking for another variation, maybe bend the knees and just let the windshield wiper. Swaying the feet side to side, side to side.
swaying back to stillness. Extend the legs long. Plant the hands and come to a seated position. Woo! Nice job, guys. Maybe you feel just a little bit warmed up. Go ahead and wipe off some sweat. Maybe take a quick sip of water, and then we'll get right to it. Now, when you're ready, coming onto your sit bones, a couple options today. Maybe you grab your block, your prop. Otherwise, you're welcome just to bring your hands to touch at your heart center. Planting your feet to the earth, squeeze knees, inner thighs together, shoulders down, lift up through your heart. As you exhale, twist to the right. Let your gaze fall. Inhale, come back center. Exhale, twist to the left. And then find your own rhythm today. I'm gonna offer a couple layers. You're welcome to stay here or you can add on as you go. So this is layer one. Layer two, you're looking for deeper. Let the shins stack, let them fall parallel to the earth. Shoulders down, lift up through the heart. Layer three, looking for more. Extend the legs nice and long. Tummy is tight. Keep your heart lifted up. Still looking for more. As you twist, drop the legs low. Bring everything back up and center. Twist. Smiling makes it easier. Always remember that. Here for last three. Breathe. Adding on two. Last one. Hold at the top. Pulse it up. Four. Three. Two. One. Nice job, guys. Set the block aside. Roll onto your back. Draw the knees in. And just sway your hips side to side, side to side. Circle the knees to the right a couple times. And then circle the knees toward the left. Keep the circles going. And then when you're ready, draw the knees in towards your heart and then open them in opposite directions. Be mindful that the bigger the knee circles, the bigger the hip opener. And then switch the circles, draw them towards the front of the room and back through your heart. Nice job, guys. Let's take two or three rocks. Cross the legs and make your way to downward facing dog. Planting the feet. On your inhale, reach your right toes toward the sky. Square the hips. Pivot that pinky toe toward the earth. Reach your right heel higher. As you exhale, listen. Right knee to the right tricep. Touch. As you exhale, extend the left, the right ankle towards the left wrist. Drop the hips low. Untuck the back toes. Proud pigeon, let your hands frame your hips, shoulders down, lift up through your heart. Again, reach, take a peek, make sure that foot's not stickled out. Inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, fold over your legs. Sleeping pigeon, forehead to a block, your interlaced hands or the mat. Slow down the breath, letting go of everything we just did. Making your way back to your palms. Tuck the back toes under, let the back knee lift off. Inhale, three-legged dog, shake it out, shake it out. Exhale, bend, open, stretch. Bending the knee, letting the hips stack. Couple layers today, this is layer one. Layer two, looking for a little bit more wild thing with control. Quietly plant the ball of the foot outside of the mat. Rainbow the hips high, arch the back. Maybe gaze for your left hand. Truly accentuate that arch for three. Two. And one, inhale, three-legged dog, right toes up. Exhale, downward facing dog. Other side, inhale, reach the left heel up. Pivot that pinky toe toward the earth. Press into your hands, reach the heel higher. Exhale, half pigeon, left knee to the left tricep. And extend that left, I can't speak today, the left ankle towards the opposite wrist. Drop your hips low, untuck the back toes. Proud pigeon. Again, let the shoulders step directly over the hips, finding some length, lifting up. Exhale, sleeping pigeon. Melt your heart towards the earth. Let the head and neck fall heavy. And then keeping your breath slow, stay there. When you're ready to move on, make your way back to your hands. Tuck the back toes, lift the knee off. Inhale, three-legged dog, left toes to the sky, shake it out as you exhale, bend, open, stretch. Let the hips step, open the knee to the sky. Layer one here, layer two. Wild thing with control, quietly plants the ball of the foot outside of the mat. Rainbow the hips to the sky, arch the back, press into the bottom hand. Let your heart open to the heavens. For three. Press into the bottom hand for two. Raise the hips higher and one. Inhale, three-legged dog. Shake it out. Exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, high plank. As you exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Untuck the toes, drop the shoulders down. Holding for an extra breath, drop the left hip, look over the right shoulder. Other side, drop the right hip, look over the left shoulder. As you exhale, downward facing dog. Couple options today. If you have your blocks, you're welcome to place them underneath your hands. Depending on what your household products are, you can place them underneath your hands too. Otherwise, bring your hands to the earth. Inhale, set the gaze forward, come up high into the tippy toes. Yogi tries to step or jump through. If you're jumping through, draw the knees in towards your chest as you jump, like so. And extend the legs long. Nice job, guys. And with your legs facing long, palms drift up. Exhale slowly. Unravel the spine vertebra by vertebra. Eventually your low back, followed by your shoulders. And your head touches the earth. Planting the feet to the mat. Draw the right knee over the right. Excuse me, the left leg, just like you're sitting at a desk and you're crossing your legs. Draw the knees in towards your body, and then open the feet wide, hands to opposite feet. Bringing the feet towards your ears. As you exhale, pull them closer to the earth. This is reclined cow face pose. Such a nice hip opener. Soften the shoulders and using the strength of your biceps and triceps. Nice job, guys. Gently release T out the arms as you exhale. Let the legs go left as your gaze falls right. Again, you're welcome to stay here. Layer one for supine twist. As long as your shoulders are glued to the earth, looking for deeper cattail pose. Right hand to that left foot. Opposite hand, left hand to the right foot. This is the next layer up. The next layer after this is to extend that right leg for three. Gaze is to the right floor, two. And one, coming out the same way you came in. Release the right foot, followed by the left. Engage the core, roll onto your low back. Unwind the legs, other side, crossing the left over right. Knees hug in towards the body, and then capture your feet. First, bring the big toes closer to your ears, and then let it drift towards the earth. Again, relax the shoulders, use the strength of the arms. Keep the navel sucked up and in for three, two, and one. T out the arms as you exhale, dropping the knees to the right, gaze pulls to the left. Keep both shoulders secured against the mat. You know your layers today. This is layer one. Layer two, you're on your way to cattail pose. Left hand to the right foot, and then the other hand to the opposite foot. Next layer up, extend that left leg long, keep both shoulders glued to the earth. Gaze is to the left for three, four, two, and one. Gently release your grip. Coming out the same way you came in, roll onto the back. Draw the knees in towards your chest, wrap your arms over your knees, your forehead, squeeze towards your big toes. Giving yourself a huge hug like you love yourself for three, come into a ball. Four, two, and one. Gently release into Shavasana. Take up space. Heels and toes roll out. Shimmy the shoulder blades underneath your heart and find absolute stillness. Only to find much mistrust. Love's gone behind. Once I had love. And it was divine. Letting your body absorb all the benefits of today's practice. Soon found out I was losing my mind.
the real thing, but I was so blind. So much mistrust, love's gone behind. In between, what I find is pleasing and I'm feeling fine. Love is so confusing, there's no peace.
Begin to deepen the breath, letting the rise and fall of the chest flow through you. On your inhale, breathing in deeply. Exhale, right ear falls to the earth. Inhale, come back to the center. Exhale, left ear to the mat. Inhale, come back center. And when you're ready to move on, you're welcome to wiggle the fingers, the toes. Maybe shift your jaw left and right. Circle at the wrist and the ankles. On your next breath, point the toes, raise the hands, however the head arches the back. And roll onto your favorite side, right or left. Bicep as a pillow, top arm as a blanket. And with a soft gaze or eyes closed, come to Sukhasana, comfortable seated position. Maybe you're kneeling, maybe your legs are crossed. Then connecting your palms back to heart center. Connecting back to yourself. Connecting back to your why. Maybe someone or something that inspires you. As you breathe in, filling up with that inspiration. As you exhale, sharing that with the world. Next breath, raising your hands up high over the head, collecting everything that you created in this class. Maybe it's that love, strength, patience, humility. Bring your palms to touch and connecting it to your third eye center, right between the eyebrows. Breathing in deeply, filling up with love and light. As you exhale, bow forward, sharing that love and light with the world. Together we say, Namaste. Thank you guys so much for practicing with me today. It was kind of a sweaty, fiery flow. I hope you guys had fun. If you are interested with practicing with me a little bit more, be sure to check out my Instagram. It'll be in the comments if you're on Facebook. Otherwise, maybe you're following me on IG Live right now. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me, message me, all that good stuff. Thank you guys. Have a great weekend. Bye now.